These are your water cycle notes. Remember, even if you're at home, I suggest you write the notes down because you tend to remember things better when you write them down. Remember, this is a cycle, so everything is either cyclical, meaning it goes around in a circle, it happens again and again. Because this is a cycle, it doesn't really matter where we start. So for us, we're just going to go on ahead and start with the sun. I've turned my paper sideways. I don't want to draw over the words, be mindful of that. I'll go on ahead and make a sun here. In order to start the cycle, we need the energy from the sun that's going to heat up our water. When the energy from that sun, thermal energy, heats up the water, it starts to evaporate. So let's go on ahead and I'm gonna pull you up a bit. Come over here and we'll draw a mountain or a hill, and we'll talk about that later, and some water. Once again, don't be like me. Don't draw in words. Like we said earlier, heat is going to cause evaporation, so the water will start to rise. Once that heat rises into the air, it starts to stick to dust and particles in the sky, and they start to form clouds. This is called condensation. Once the water forms in these clouds, it'll get too heavy eventually, and the rain, sleet, snow, or hail will start to fall from those clouds depending on the temperature. So all of this rain, sleet, snow, hail, whatever we have, is going to go onto our ground. Now, it can go immediately into a body of water. It can go to a puddle. It could run off of a hill, which is what we're going to talk about next. There's many different places that the cycle could go from here, but we always want to include as many things as possible. So, runoff. This is just water moving down a hill. There's nothing special about it. Water moving down a hill. It doesn't have to be a hill. It can be a mountain. It can be any other type of landform, as long as it has a side to run off of. These things run off into a body of water. Ocean, sea, lake, river, any body of water. This is called two things, accumulation or collection. You could see it both ways. This is just where water gathers. Last part I want to talk about is transpiration, which is something you may or may not have heard of before. Let's say you have a plant. We're going to talk about transpiration in another video, but you do need to know that basically all that's happening is that water is coming out of a plant's leaves, or it's leaving the plant, and it's evaporating into the sky, into the sky, so that it can form those clouds. Okay, make sure that you guys have everything written down, and we're going to be going over this for the rest of the week and a little bit next week.